Hello everybody. Recently I got this valve that is an motor valve which is composed by one ball valve and then an electric motor that open and close the valve. As you can see now it's open. I just want to show how it works and what I found because at the beginning I just want to test power consumption. If we consume power during the closed state or open state, but then it became something more interesting that you will see along in this video. This valve has some specific application, and instead of using the standard solenoid valve, can be used for example, for application where it doesn't not switch on and off very frequently, but it has to keep the state. So now let's connect the wires and make some testing. So this is the original circuitry. The valve is closed and connection with the relay. So now let's try to open the valve and see what happened. On the display we have also the current, so it measure how many milliampere pass through the system. Let's try to open it. Okay, now it's over, and that is around 18 milliampere consumption. Okay, now it's closed. So it works in this way. There are two switches that when it reach open or close position, they open the circuitry, so there should be no power consumption. But as you can see, when the valve is open, there is some consumption, even if it is full open. Let's see again with the longer time period. So the consumption with the motor and the relay, because internally there is a relay, is about 45. Then, when it reaches the open position, only the relay is on and it consumes around 18 milliampere. I think this can be fixed if the circuit inside is changed using a little more clever connection setup. So I will try to modify this circuitry internal to the valve and see if I can leave the valve open with no power consumption. As you can see, when the valve goes back to closed state, there is no power consumption, so there is 0 milliampere consumption. I want to achieve the same also when the position is fully open. Let's try to modify the circuitry. So now I open the valve to see what is inside. And this is what I found. So there is a relay that it's a dual switch relay that will invert the polarity for the motor. Then we have the wires that go to the motor, and you can see maybe if you see these two white spots, one here and the other here, these are the end switches. Indeed, I also dismount the circuitry and reproduce it in this diagram. So we have the relay which has two commons. One here and one here. And this relay is made in the way that there are two independent switches, one above and one below. And then this switch is normally closed here and normally open with this one, with the other contact. And the same for this one. This is the common, normally closed, normally open. The yellow is the ground. And when we use the blue, the relay is not activated, so it works with the normally closed. So we have blue going to this wire on the motor, and the yellow going to this wire on the motor. When the closed position is reached, this end switch open, and then we have zero power consumption. On the opposite, when we want to open and keep the valve open, we put the positive on the red And this here and here, and the yellow is the ground. So what happened? That the relay activates, so the normal yob this time became close and contact with the motor, and then the motor activate until at one point it reached the open state, and then the power to the motor is cut. But the point is that the power to the coil is not cut. I think this can be solved by changing the connection of the, and not connecting the coil directly to the yellow, but after the end switch for the open position. So I will try to make this modification to the circuitry and see what happens. So the modification that I want to make is in red. So instead of connecting the coil of the relay to the yellow directly, I will make a connection to the yellow, but after that pass the open switch. So when it's fully open, this switch will open contact and we will not have any more coil activated. So now let's try to see if this works. Okay, so I made the modification to the circuitry. It was very easy to make indeed. Now let's see if things works as expected. Now I keep the relay on for 10 seconds. Okay, the valve is open and power consumption is zero. Okay, valve is closed and power consumption is zero. So as you can see, with the very simple modification to the circuitry, now we have something that works better. Let's try again. 10 seconds. Okay, work properly now. I have to say another thing. So the when I bought this this valve from a Chinese supplier, they provide me this piece of paper, and with the color of the wires and the connections, and I say I was very happy with that. But unfortunately, this is wrong, and it happened that the yellow is indeed the ground. It has to go to negative, and red is open and blue is closed. So be careful. I mean, the product is seems quite good, but they just miss the details. I hope you find this video useful, and thank you for watching.